Hello children, let me welcome you to the virtual class of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher. Children, we are in the middle of this COVID-19 pandemic and because of that we are not able to go to school, but that doesn't mean we are going to stop learning. So we are going to do many lessons which are very interesting from your textbook through the virtual class here. So let us do a lesson in English today. So come on children, let us start with another lesson in standard 5th scholarship, and the subject for today will be English. And children, the topic that we are going to do today is another topic based on vocabulary, and that is topic number 1.13. That is the 13th topic in the vocabulary section in your textbook, and the name of the lesson is alphabetical order. Now children, where have you seen alphabetical order being used? Have you ever seen a place where words are arranged according to alphabetical order? I'm sure you must have, because we see it in the dictionary. Okay, so what is the meaning of writing letters in alphabetical order in a word? Now in this kind of exercise, you will be expected to arrange words in alphabetical order as they appear in a dictionary. So we all know that in a dictionary, certain words come before certain other words. Okay, for example, if you look at EAT, it will come first, and another word like ELEPHANT will come later. Okay, why? Because they appear according to the letters in the word. Now it will make the idea clear to you. Let me show you this particular chart where we have all the letters of the alphabet. So you can see A comes before B and C comes after B and so on and so forth. So once you know the order of the letters in the alphabet, you will be able to arrange words also which are given to you. For example, if there is a word with H and if there is a word with M, which word will you write first? You will write the word with the H first and the M later. Why? Because H comes first in the alphabet and M comes later in the alphabet. Okay, so it is as simple as that. And if you have used dictionaries, then I'm sure this is very, very easy for you. You're going to find it very, very simple. Only thing is, you have to be very careful while reading the words. And sometimes you will see that the first letters are all the same, the second letters in the word are also all the same, but the third letter changes, and then you have to be extra careful. But don't worry, we are going to see a lot of examples also, and we are going to do many questions also based on the examples which are there for you in the book. Alright children, so remember, what are you supposed to do in an exercise based on alphabetical order? You are just supposed to arrange the words in alphabetical order as they appear in the dictionary. And this is how the words appear in the dictionary. The words starting with A come first, and then after all the words starting with A are over, then you have words starting with B and then C and then D and so on and so forth. Okay, so this was a little bit of theory about alphabetical order. Let us now move on and let us take a look at some examples. So see, here you have CAT cat, JOKE joke, BALL ball, and DOG dog. So which is the one which will come first? Which word will come first? Will cat come first, or joke come first, or ball come first, or dog come first? So according to me, ball will come first. Why? Because it starts with a B. And then in the alphabet, after A you have B. And after B you have C. So you have cat coming next. Okay? And then you have dog coming next. And finally, in this particular list, you have the last word, that is joke. So you have ball, cat, dog, joke. Okay? So this was the first example for you. Now look at all the other words, all the other lists. They are very, very similar. Okay, so now what you should do, you try and pause the video and try to find out the answers yourself, and then come on, let us check your answers with mine. So in list B, the first word that you will write is flag. Then, after flag, A, B, C, D, E, F, then you have G. So, you write goat. And then you know Z, O, O, zoo. Z is the last letter in the alphabet. So, naturally, sun will come before zoo. So, you have the order F, G, S, Z. So, it is flag, zoo, goat, sun will come as flag, goat, sun, zoo. Let us take a look at the next one. But before that, the remaining answers. Okay, the remaining exercise, I will leave it for you to solve. So, let me just help you with the very next one. And the D and the E, you can do it yourself. So, you have year, box, horse and coat. So, come on, say the letters of the alphabet A, B. Okay, so you have box first and then you have C. So, you have coat next. Then you have A, B, C, D, E. So, you have year and finally you have horse. Okay, and in the same manner, try and write the answers to the next two also. So, it will be a little bit of practice for you to do. Alright, children. So, this is one kind of exercise where you will learn so many examples about how number letters can be arranged or words can be arranged according to their letters. Done. Let us move on and let us go to the next kind of exercise now. So, see, here you have, like I told you, all the letters, all the words here are starting with the same letter. So, in the previous example, we had one word starting with E and the other one starting with B. Then you had one starting with H and then C. So, here it was clear for us that you will write B first and then C, then E and then finally H. But then look at this exercise here. All the words are starting with the same letter. So, you have sat, you have sit, you have stop, you have slip, small and ship. So, now what do? Now you take a look at the second letter. So, when the first letters are the same, you will have to go to the second letter to see which word will come first, which word will come second. So, let us look at the first word, S-A-T, sat. And you have S-I, then you have S-T, then you have S-L, then S-M and S-H. So, naturally, which is the first letter of the alphabet? It is A. So, S-A-T will come first. After that, then you come on, say the letters of the alphabet A, then you have B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Alright, so you have ship coming next, S-H-I-P. Then you have H-I, so sit comes next. Okay, and then similarly if you go on saying A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Then you have K, then you have L, so you have the slip written here. And then you have M, so you have small written here. And finally you have T, okay? So you have the stop written here. So this is how you will put up a list or you will compile a list where the first letters of the word are the same. So then what are you supposed to focus on? You're supposed to focus on the next letter. And what if the next letter is also the same? Then what will you do? Then you will go on to the third letter. You will focus on the third letter. Okay? So this is how you will try and solve exercises based on alphabetical order. Okay, children? So I hope you understood what we are trying to do over here and how we are going to do it. So now let us go to the question patterns. So here you can have three different types of questions. So let us take pattern one. So it is very simple. You have to arrange the words alphabetically and you have to identify the word as instructed. As instructed means there will be a particular instruction for each question. So you have to follow that instruction. But remember, while following the instruction also, you will still arrange the words alphabetically. So the basic exercise here is arranging the words alphabetically. But what will you do? You will also follow the instruction which is given to you along with the question. So this was the first one. Let's go to the second pattern. which is the correct alphabetical order of the following words. So we just did it now. So there were certain words which were given to us and we put them in correct alphabetical order. So that is what you have to do here. Coming to pattern 3. If you arrange the following words in the alphabetical order, the word XXXX, so dash, a particular word, that word will change according to each question, will come in the dash place. Okay, so you will have 4 words given to you. So you will have to arrange the 4 words according to the alphabetical order. And then one particular word will be marked for you. So that word will come in the first place or the second place or the third place or the fourth place, you will have to say. Now there are 4 words, isn't it? You always have 4 options for your scholarship answer. So you have 4 words. So whether it will come in the first place, second, third or fourth place, you will have to decide. If you're still confused with the pattern of the question, don't worry. When we solve the questions, when we do examples, you will understand them very well. Okay, children. So these were the question patterns as far as alphabetical order is concerned. Let us now move on and let us take a look at certain example questions. So we will start with pattern 1. Arrange the words alphabetically and identify the word as instructed. So let us see what the word is. So you have to identify the third word. Okay, you have to arrange it alphabetically and then you have to identify which the third word in the list will be. So let us take a look at the words. So you have rain, R-A-I-N, rain, R-E-I-G-N, rain, R-E-I-N, rain, and R-A-V-E-N, raven. So see, the 3 spellings are very close. Okay, the 3 pronunciations, the 3 words are very close as far as the sound is concerned. So you have R-A-I-N, rain, R-E-I-G-N, rain, R-E-I-N, rain, and R-A-V-E-N, raven. You know the meaning of all these words? Rain means barish. And the second one, R-E-I-G-N, rain, means the rule of a king. The third one, R-E-I-N, rain, means the kind of device they use to control horses, cows, etc. And raven means a black color crow. So these are the words and the meanings. So now let us see which word, after you arrange them alphabetically, which word will come in the third position or which word will be third in the list. So which word will be third? Will it be R-A-I-N? Will it be R-E-I-N? Will it be R-E-I-N or R-A-V-E-N? So which word is going to come third in the list? So out of 1, 2, 3 and 4, what do you think? So come on, let us try and do it a little bit on our level. So you have R-A-I-N and R-A-V-E-N. So R-A and R-A will come first. Okay, so R-A-I-N will come first, R-A-V-E-N will come next. Now the third word will be either R-E-I-G-N or R-E-I-N. So now say the letters of the alphabet A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So G comes first, N comes later. So R-E-I-G-N will come third and R-E-I-N will come fourth. So that is the way you count it. Now it will not take so much time, children. Now I'm explaining this to you, that is why it is taking time. But once you get used to it, you will be able to do it very quickly. Okay, so let us see whether what we calculated is correct. Yes, R-E-I-G-N will come third and R-E-I-N will come last. And of course, R-A-I-N will come first. Okay, and how will you explain it? Between R-E-I-N and R-E-I-G-N, G comes before N in the alphabet. Okay, so the G, the fourth word. Now see, the first word is, first letter is same. R, second letter is same, E, third letter is same, I. So we had to pick up the fourth one to decide which will come first, which will come later. Alright, children. So which is the letter, which is the word which will come third? It is the word R-E-I-G-N. Alright, so isn't it simple? It is very simple. Let's go to example number 2. The fourth word. So again, we take a look at these 4 words and decide which word will come fourth. So now this looks much more easy. Why? Because all the words are starting with different letters of the alphabet. So for you it is going to be easier than the previous one. Okay, so come on, let us check out whether it will be B which comes first, elephant comes first, or second ass, or third bee, or fourth fox. So which one will come first, children? Sorry, which one will come fourth? Yes, it will be the fourth one, fox. Why? Because ass will come first, bee will come second, elephant will come third, and fox will come fourth. So the letter F, that is F for fox, comes after A for elephant, B for bee, and E for elephant. A for ass, B for bee, and E for elephant in the alphabet. Okay, now once I finish saying the answer, pause the video and take a look at this question again from your angle. Okay, because I'm keeping on repeating these letters of the alphabet, it might sound a little confusing, but if you try and understand it well, patiently, it is very, very simple. All right, coming to the next example in this particular pattern. So the second word, so you have these four words, grass, grasp, grieve, and great. So now when you look at these four words, you automatically understand that the second word will either be grass or grasp. Okay, because A comes before I in the grieve or E in the great. So leave out the second, third, and the last word now. So the competition is going to be between grass and grasp. So let us see which one will come second. So will it be grass, will it be grasp, or grieve and great? To be already minused them. So what will the answer be? So the second word will be grass. Grasp will come first. Why? Because between grass and grasp, S comes after P in the alphabet. So G-R-A-S, both were same. But when P came up, P comes first and S comes later. S comes after P. So you have grasp, which will be the first word, and grass, which will be the next word. Okay, children, come on, let's move on to the next question. So the word is the second word. You have to identify the second word from this list. So you have sir, see, saw, and sun. So which word will be the second word? Again, you have all the words starting with S, but then you can stop at the second letters here. So the second letter in the first word sir is I, in the second word see is E, in the third word saw is A, and in the fourth word sun is U. So come on, let us identify and let us see which will be the second word in the list. So will it be sun, will it be sir, will it be saw, or will it be see? So what will be the second word in the list, children? It will be C, because after A you have B, C, D, and E, and afterwards you have I and U. Okay, so the answer is C. Why? Because between saw and C, E comes after A. All right, so that is the reason. Now coming to the last question in this particular pattern, you have ache, you have ask, you have able, and you have atomic. So now you have to write the correct alphabetical order of the following words. So this is the second pattern, pattern number 2, which is the correct alphabetical order of the following words. So how will you arrange them in alphabetical order? So all of them are starting with the letter A, so you will have to focus on the second letters. So you have C as a second letter in the first word, S as a second letter in the second word, B as a second letter in the third word, and T as a second letter in the fourth word. So now I think it might be quite easy for you. Okay, so will it be A, B, C, D, that is ache, ask, able, atomic, or will it be D, A, B, C, that is D is atomic, ache, ask, and able, or will it be DBAC, that is atomic, ask, ache, and able, or will it be CABD, that is able, ache, and then you have ask, and finally you have atomic. So which will be the correct alphabetical order of the words? Which will it be? Yes, it will be the fourth one, C-A-B-D. Because you will write able, A-B first. Then you will write ache, A-C second. And then you will write A-S, ask third. And finally, A-T-O-M-I-C, atomic last. So what will be the order? It will be C-A-B-D. Okay, children? Now come on, let's move on to the next question in this pattern and see how will we arrange it. We will arrange it as able, ache, atomic, sorry, ask and atomic. Alright, let us move on to the next question in this particular pattern. So you have that, tennis, father and fathom. Okay, so two words starting with T and two words starting with F. So now the words starting with F will come before the words starting with T. But there also, if you take a look, F and F is the same. First letters are same, second are the same, third also are the same, and fourth also are the same. Then you have to go for the fifth letters, that is E and O, and decide which comes first. Anyways, think about it, take a proper look, and try and write what the answer is. So will it be ABCD? Will it be DABC? Will it be CDBA? Or will it be CABD? So what do you think? Let us check out. It will be the third pattern, C, D, B and A. How? Let's see. So C is what? C is father, D is fathom, B is tennis and A is that. So see the letters of the alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, so E comes before O and E comes before H. So take a look at the words properly. You will understand how they are put in this particular order. Coming to the next question in this pattern or next example in this pattern. See now, you have cat, you have cattle, you have caterpillar and you have catfish. All the words starting with the three letters cat. And then they go further and add a T, then they add a E, then they add a F. So come on, let us see which will be the right pattern. So will it be ACDB? Will it be DABC? Will it be DBAC or CABD? So let us check out. It will be which one? The first one. ACD and B. So A is cat, C is caterpillar, D is catfish, and then you have cattle. Okay, so C-A-T cat is alone. There is no letter after the T here, so that you put it first. Okay, and then caterpillar, after T you have E, so it goes second. Then in catfish, after T you have F, so it goes third. And finally you have the last remaining one, that is cattle. Okay, so this was the next example in pattern 2. Let us see how it is little be written in order. It will be written as cat, caterpillar, catfish and cattle. Okay, let us go on to the next question in this pattern. So you have violet, indigo, blue and green. Now these are the colors of the rainbow. We cannot write all seven colors because we are allowed to give only four options here. So what pattern will they fall into? Will it be ABCD, CDBA, DBAC or CABD? Check out what the answer could be. Work it out for yourself. Yes, it will be the second one. That is C. Okay? Blue. And then you have D, green. And then you have B, indigo. And then finally you have V. Now here all of them are starting with different letters. So they are a little easy on you. Alright, coming to the next question here in this pattern. See, you have these words. Recent, decent, innocent, magnificent. Now here all the last letters are the same. Sent, 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 sent. Should it interfere with your alphabetical order? Not at all. Why? Because when we consider alphabetical order, we look at the first letters, okay, or then if the first letters are same, we go to the second letters, or then we go to the third letters. What the last letters are, we hardly check out first. So come on, Let us do our same exercise. So here the pattern, answer pattern is a little different. So will it be written as 1, decent, innocent, magnificent, recent? Or will it be recent, innocent, decent, magnificent? Or will it be recent, magnificent, decent, innocent? Or magnificent, innocent, decent, recent? So which will be the correct answer? Yes, it will be the first option, because D comes before I, and I comes before M, and M comes before R in the letters of the alphabet. So you have decent, innocent, magnificent, and recent. Okay, coming to the last pattern, in last question example in this pattern, grind, grain, graft, grape. So what will be the correct alphabetical order? Will it be grain, grind, grape, graft? Grape, grain, grind, graft? Graft, grain, grape, grind? Or graft, grape, grain, grind? Again, all of them are starting with a G. All of them have the second letter R. But the third one goes on changing. So come on, let us see which the correct order will be. Yes, it will be answer number 3. That is G-R-A-F-T, graft. G-R-A-I-N, grain. G-R-A-P-E, grape. And G-R-I-N-D, grind. Okay. So this was pattern number 2 for you children. Let's move on and do pattern number 3 now. So the pattern number 3 is a little different from the previous two, but then remember, the way you find out the answer is the same. So if you arrange the following words in alphabetical order, the word X, so which word I will tell you now, will come in the dash place. Okay, so what is the word? The word is perfume. And you are supposed to see which word, this word perfume, will come in which place. Okay, and this is a list of words. So perhaps, perfume, perfect, and perform. So these are the four words out of which you are supposed to find out that the word perfume, when you arrange these four words in the correct order, the word perfume will come in which place. So will it come in the first place, second place, third place, or fourth place? You're supposed to think and tell now. So come on, think which place the word perfume will come. Will it be first, second, third, or fourth? So the word perfume will come in the third place. How? The first will be perfect, second will be perform, third will be perfume, and then you will have perhaps. Okay, so A, B, C, D, E, F, and then you have H. That is why you put the perhaps last. And out of E, O, and U, you have E which comes first, so perfect will come first, then you have perform. So our word perfume will come third in the list. Isn't it simple? Only the question has been worded in a different way. Moving on to the next example over here. Example word will be best. So you have to find out what will be the position of best in this list if it is arranged alphabetically. So take a look. All the words start with B, but the second letters are different. So come on, let's decide. Will best come in the third place, first place, second place, or fourth place? Where will it come? It will come in the second place. Let's see how. So you have the first word bark, then you have best, then you have bird, and then you have burn. So our word best comes in the second place. Okay, so the answer is answer number 3, second place. Let's move on to do the next example here. So you have the word heel, H-E-E-L, heel. So where will you put it in a list where there are the words here, H-A-R, here, H-A-I-R, hair, heel, and H-A-R-E, hair? So where will it come? Third, first, second, or fourth? It will come in the fourth place. So how? It will be H-A-I-R, hair, H-A-R-E, hair, H-E-A-R, here, and H-E-E-L, heel. So I have purposely given these words which mark the position in a different color. Alright? So the first word I will mark the position, In the second word, R will mark the position and so on. Alright, children. So, this was all for today. And now, after you finish watching the video, you will have to do certain small exercises based on the video. And what those exercises are, I will explain to you right now. But remember, what all did we do today? We talked about alphabetical order. And we looked and we decided how words are arranged in alphabetical order, like they are done in the dictionary. We also looked at the three patterns of questions that could be asked. And we also solved various examples based on the patterns. So children, now you have watched the video. So after you watch the video now, you will have to complete a few simple tasks. Now you might have watched the video on your computers or your laptops or your mobile phones. Now after you watch the video, what will you do? You will please go to the description box which is given below the video. So what is the description box? See, the description box looks like this. Alright, and after you go to the description box, you will see that there are a few questions there. Now, what are these questions about? These questions are about the lesson that we just learned or the video that you just watched. So, what will you do? You will think back properly about the lesson and you will try and answer these questions and note down the answers in your notebook if you want. Okay, after that, we have another task waiting. You will also click on the link which you will find in the description box to fill up the Google form. So now what is the Google form, children? It is nothing but a simple form. There are a few simple questions there about the video which you just saw and also about yourself. So these are the tasks now that you will have to complete after you watch each video. So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learned a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.